Hello everybody, my name is Foley and welcome to my 27 code lock 4x4 piston door showcase video. In this video I will show you my design. It is quite big, but that is because the size makes it easier to explain what's going on. If you want to build this lock on your own Minecraft build, you can make it any size you want and on anything you want.
My lock uses 5 different parts. Each part has its own color. I will explain the most important things that you need to know if you want to build your own lock. So, I will begin with the red part. The task of the red part is checking if the code has been entered correctly. The first thing that needs to be done is to fill in the gaps between the items. The easiest way to do that is with unstackable items. I use swords for that. When the minecart is filled up, it will be sent off. It then passes different item sorting systems, where it will only deliver one item per system. These item sorting systems check if the items they receive are the right ones according to the passport. When the items match up, the minecart will continue its way to the other sorting systems. However, when an item is not matching up with the passport, the minecart will be sent to the so-called reset section. The reset section clears the minecart from all its contents. Then the minecart will be sent back to the player. We also give an output to the player that the passport was incorrect. When the minecart has been approved by the other sorting systems, the process will repeat itself in a new row. The only difference being that the sorting systems are looking for different items in a new row. The minecart will still be sent to the same reset section when its items don't match up with the passport. But in the last row, there is a difference. This row is divided into two pieces. The first piece checks all remaining items except the last one. If there's a wrong item, the minecart will not have permission to go to the second part and will be sent to the reset section. In the second part, the last item will be checked. If this one matches up with the passport, the door will be opened. After that, the minecart will be sent to the reset section and be prepared for the next time. In this video I will no longer explain anything about the red part. If you find it interesting, there's a world download in the description. Now about the purple part. Its task is to make sure all items return to the place they belong. That's an easy task to do. First, all items that have been sorted should get to these two droppers. All the hoppers with the purple block underneath will handle this. The two droppers will shoot the items in a water stream. This water stream will bring the items to an item filter. This filter will split the sword and the banners up. When the minecart arrives at the reset section, it will dispose all the leftover items at one of the two droppers. The system used to shoot the items in a water stream is pretty simple. The comparator gives a single when it contains an item. This will reset the comparator and make the dropper shoot at the same time. The item will get to the water elevator, which elevates the item into the water stream. Next up, I will explain the yellow and the green parts. I'll explain them both at the same time because they are very similar. All the yellow blocks that you see are unstackable item sorting systems. They check the items that come in if they are swords and not banners. First thing you need to know is that hoppers intend to go down. But when they can't, they choose another direction. For example, if the hopper beneath is full or being powered. The second thing you need to know is that the stackable item gives an output of 1, while an unstackable item gives an output of 3. So if a sword comes in, the redstone torch gets unpowered as well as the hopper beneath. And so the sword will go down. But if a banner comes in, the hopper stays powered, so the banner goes to the right. All the green blocks you see are stackable item sorting systems. They check if the item that comes in is the right one according to the password. To make this work, the same principle that hoppers intend to go down, but when they can't, they choose another direction, gets used again. In this situation, the hopper is almost full. There's only room for one more white banner. If this last banner comes in, the comparator will give an output of 15. And that's enough to power the redstone next to it. This happens only at an output of 15 because the comparator gets powered by a single strength of 15. So if this happens, the hopper beneath the full hopper gets unpowered for the split second, in which exactly one banner can leave the full hopper. And this, of course, works with any color banner. Now I will explain the last part, orange. Orange takes care of opening the door and turning on more lights in the hallway. The lamps in the hallway are always turned on until the player puts in a code. Then the lights turn off. The minecart rides over a detector rail. This rail sends a signal to a T flip-flop. And the T flip-flop sends a signal to two points. One point makes sure that all the lamps turn off. The other point makes the lamp stay turned off and the wall closed until the whole system has been reset. Each time an item has been sorted and brought back to the waterline, a short signal will be sent to a dropper. The dropper then fires a sword into the hopper. This makes a piston push a redstone block. The redstone block activates a few lamps. As soon as the first dropper has shot all its swords, a path will be created. This will enable the next dropper to be activated. This process will repeat itself once. Thanks for watching this video. I hope you found it useful. If so, consider liking or even subscribing to my channel for more content like this. It took a little while to make this video, so it will help a lot. Goodbye!